Yes, sir. Yes, it's okay.
Is there any problem in live streaming, Ravinder?
Sir, I am facing internet connection issues, but I think it is okay, live okay. Now.
It's live now. Yeah. Good morning, everyone. I, Dr. Vinita Tully, welcome you all to the webinar on A New Look at Energy and Sustainability, organized under the aegis of IQAC of Atmaram Snatan Dharma College, University of Delhi, in collaboration with the Department of Physics. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome our distinguished speaker, Professor Chetan Singh Solanki, the Solar Man of India, professor at the Department of Energy Sciences and Engineering, IIT Bombay, and founder of the Energy Swaraj Foundation. Sir, we are really honored to have you with us and glad that you took out time from your busy schedule to speak on this webinar and enlighten us on the topic, A New Look at Energy and Sustainability, which is a very relevant and pertinent topic, which means that sustainable energy is power which is able to be replenished within a human lifetime and so causes no long-term damage to environment. We also have with us our principal, Dr. Gyantosh Kumar Jha. I welcome him also, under whose leadership the college has reached new heights and our college achieved rank 13th in the college category announced by the NIRF, MHRD. I invite him to welcome our distinguished guests and say a few words.
Thank you, Vinita. This distinguished Professor Chetan Singh Solanki, professor in IIT Mumbai and founder Swaraj Foundation, and today's webinar speaker, Dr. Vinita Tully, convener webinar committee, other colleagues, and my dear student. On behalf of Atmaram Sanatan Dharma College, I welcome you all in this webinar. I am glad that Professor Solanki has given us his valuable time to deliver his lecture on solar energy. And I think this lecture is going to a milestone in the study of solar energy. I am proud and I am privileged that Professor Solanki has given his consent to deliver his lecture for the benefit of our students, teachers, as well as researchers. So thank you so much, sir. I express my gratitude and heartfelt thanks to you for giving you your time. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you so much. Over to Vinita.
Thank you, sir. Professor Chetan Singh Solanki is a professor at IIT Bombay and founder Energy Swaraj Foundation. Following Gandhian ideals, Professor Solanki has envisaged the idea of Energy Swaraj, where locals generate and consume their own energy. Energy Swaraj is now a key instrument towards sustainability and climate change mitigation. Professor Solanki has been referred as the Solar Man of India by the Times of India, the Hindu, and the India Today. Some people also call him Solar Gandhi, known for his remarkable work in the field of solar energy. He's an educator, innovator, researcher, entrepreneur, and author. He received his PhD from IMEC, Catholic University, Belgium, a leading R&D and research and development and innovation hub in micro and nano electronics. He had led major solar projects at IIT Mumbai, including the National Center for Photovoltaic Research and Education, which is one of the leading research centers in India, and the Solar Urja through Localization for Sustainability Initiative, which through its Clean Light Initiative has reached 8.5 million families. Professor Solanki has authored 7 books, published over 100 research papers in international journals, and has 4 US patents to his credit. His contribution to solar energy has been immense. Following the Gandhian ideals, he has coined the word Energy Swaraj and has authored his thoughts in the book Energy Swaraj, My Experiments with Solar Truth. He has founded Energy Swaraj Foundation, a not-for-profit organization to establish Energy Swaraj across the globe through public movement. He has won many awards and accolades for his work, and to name a few, IEEE Globe Grand Prize, 2 Guinness World Records in Environment Sustainability Lesson, and most people assembling solar-powered lamps simultaneously. First prize in ONGC Solar Chulha Challenge, Guinness World Record in most LED lights lit simultaneously on 2nd October 2018. Prime Minister's Award for Innovation in the year 2017. I welcome you again, sir, and invite you to speak on the topic.
Thank you very much, Dr. Vinita. Thank you very much, Professor Gyantosh. And it is really my pleasure to talk to all of you today. And before I talk about a new look on energy and sustainability, let us have a look at our own energy and our own energy levels. You know, first of all, I'm very happy to read this name, Atmaram Sanatan Dharma College. I mean, it really feels nice that the philosophy of Sanatan Dharma is there in the name itself. And we should all be really worrying and looking at our own energy. And if humans are on a positive energy, it always results in a good work around us, isn't it? So when we are in a good energy, high energy, we are in a good mood, we tend to forgive people, we tend to let go small things. And on the other end, we are in a poor energy, low energy, we get irritated, we think negative. So it's very important to be in a good energy, number one, and positive energy. And that's why in my office, nobody is allowed to be okay or fine. You know, when I asked Dr. Vinita, how are you? She said, fine. I said, only fine. You know, as a human, you know, Gita says that, you know, we keep doing a lot of activities in our life. And in Gita, as per the Gita, that every single activity that we do has only one purpose, you know, that is to derive happiness. You know, whether we want to eat ice cream, or we want to look good, or we want to wear new clothes, or we want to study well and recognize. Behind each and every act, the only purpose is to be happy. But what really happens around us, that we are never happy. You know, we, people keep asking us, you know, how are you? And we keep giving, you know, I'm fine, I'm okay. And we are fine, okay, whole life. We are never happy. We never say that I'm happy, you know. It's so, people feel so hesitant to say that I'm happy, isn't it? So in my office, it is not allowed to be okay or fine. We can only be happy because we are already very lucky people who are sitting here right now in front of computer, able to use technology and listen to people all around the world, isn't it? So there is one condition that I always put, if you want to attend my lecture, that you have to be happy and smiling. So let me ask all of you once again, how are you all? How are you all? Happy? Wonderful. I hope that you are happy. You know, otherwise, you are not allowed to. Great. Very nice. Otherwise, you are not allowed to attend this lecture. All right. So let me share my screen. And then I'm going to talk about a new look on energy. And I think it is very important that we understand how we live our day-to-day life. And unfortunately, 99% people are not even aware what is happening. And as a result of that, we do not take right action, right decision. So I hope you are able to see my screen now.
Yes, sir. yes, we are able to see. It's clear.
Okay, great. So I hope this lecture and this discussion today will be a beginning of a new life and lifestyle and new chapter in your life. Because if you are not going to understand the energy and the sustainability properly, you are never going to find a right solution. All right. So what I'm going to do is, I want to bring you to your notice that the science that we know, or the science that human beings have been discovering for centuries, is a very little portion of the knowledge that is that exists in the nature, in the universe. And therefore I say that, you know, actually we know nothing, you know, we really do not know much. And there is a very nice story behind it. You know, there is, I'm sure all of you know, Rishi Vedvyas, right? And the Rishi Vedvyas really wanted to gain knowledge. He really wanted to have the knowledge. And he was doing tapasya, and once, you know, Mother Nature got happy and came to Rishi Vyas, you know, tell me what you want. So he said, you know, I want knowledge, you know. So the Mother Nature took him by holding his finger and brought him in front of a big mountain of knowledge. You know, lots of books were there. And then Mother Nature told him, okay, grab whatever you can within your capacity. So the Rishi Vyas, you know, could grab only four books, and those four books are the four Ved that we know. And it is said that to read one Ved, we need 12 years. And to understand one Ved, we need 120 years. You know, so just reading a four Ved that we have require several lifetimes. And the knowledge that exists in the universe is really infinite. So we need to really understand that actually we know nothing. And there are many examples that will tell you that we know nothing. So what I'm going to do in this lecture today is, I will give an example, what kind of world we live in, just giving you sense of how do we live. And then we'll come about energy, that energy is a major driver of our life and what we are doing with it. How does the energy is related to the climate change? And eventually, what could be the way out and the solution in the form of energy storage? All right. So let me begin with this particular image. I hope all of you know this image. This is an image of a universe. You know? So this is an image of a universe where there are, I know, lakhs and lakhs of galaxies are there. And only one such galaxy is ours. We call it Milky Way, and which the Milky Way looks like this. This is our galaxy where we live in. Now, within this galaxy, there are billions of stars, literally billions of stars, and only one star is ours. And if I ask you, where is our star? Many people point in the center of the screen, the bright spot, which is not correct. Our star is somewhere down below in the middle, a small tiny dot. So in the entire universe, there are many galaxies. Within many galaxies, one galaxy is ours. In our galaxy, there are billions of stars. Within that, only one star is ours, which is Sun. And around the Sun, there are many planets which are revolving. And only one little tiny planet is ours, the Earth. Can you see this Earth here as compared to the Sun? It's really tiny, you know? It's 109 times smaller than the diameter of the Earth. So very tiny place is our home. We call it Earth. And around the Earth also, there is a very small, thin blue layer where human life is possible, right? This is the blue layer where there is a right atmosphere, there's a right amount of carbon dioxide, there's a right amount of oxygen, and we can live as a human being only in this blue layer. In the entire infinity of the sky and universe, we cannot live anywhere else except this layer. So when something is so precious, we must be really taking good care of it, isn't it? We must be really worrying and bothering about this blue layer. We must be doing a lot of efforts to, you know, help it out and correct it. But which we're actually not doing it. I'm coming to that. So this, within this blue layer, there is such a beautiful world that used to exist. I'm using the word used to exist. That doesn't exist anymore. So nice clean water, nice flora and fauna, nice dense forest, lush green dense forest, very clean rivers, very fertile soil. And this was the characteristic of the planet Earth, which was originally there once upon a time. But it is not the same anymore. Why? Because we started using energy. We learned how to use energy. And why do we do this? Because energy is a major driver for life. If you look at all our life, day-to-day life, morning to evening to night, there is not a single minute where we are not using energy. And there is not a single square inch of space where energy is not utilized, right? So every space around us, every minute around us, we are using energy. So energy is a major driver, and it affects entire social growth. It affects entire economic growth. Everything is energy, right? In fact, there are sustainable development goals, which is called SDGs. And there are 17 sustainable development goals. One of the goal number 7, which is in the center of this image, is goal number 7, sustainable development goal 7. It actually tells that the goal is by the set up by United Nations that every individual on the planet should have access to clean, modern, affordable, and sustainable renewable energy solutions. Clean, modern, affordable. And if you do that, it has connection with every issue or the problem or the solution in the world, you know, whether it is about poverty, hunger, you know, the health, education, gender, sanitation, economic growth, industrialization, everything, even peace has a correlation with energy. The global partnership has a correlation with energy. So that is a great thing. We need to consume more energy, and that is what the world over people are trying to do, consume more and more energy, you know. And there has been a very strong correlationship between energy and GDP, energy and health, energy and income, energy and education. Everything is correlated. However, there is one problem, that energy and the climate change are in the opposite direction. So the goal number 13 and goal number 7 are exactly in opposite direction. If you increase your energy consumption, your climate change will become worse. Why? Because 80% of energy that we consume today are derived from the fossil energy. And the fossil energy, coal, oil, gas, all carbon source. And whenever you burn a carbon source in the vehicle, in the power plant, what happens? You actually emit carbon dioxide. The end product is carbon dioxide. So you are emitting carbon dioxide, and the carbon dioxide is creating problem. As you can see here, the amount of carbon dioxide that is accumulated on the Earth atmosphere has been increasing tremendously, you know. So you can see it has been constant for a lot of time. It was constant, and it was really not improving. So this graph is for the last 1,000 years. And last 1,000 years, the concentration of the CO2 in the atmosphere was constant around 280 parts per million. Here, the concentration is given in ppm, the parts per million. But look at what is happening after the industrialization. After 1850, the CO2 concentration started increasing, and now it is increasing super fast. And it is almost increasing exponentially. And carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas. What it is doing, it is causing the greenhouse effect. What is greenhouse effect? It is warming the atmosphere. It is warming the planet Earth. As a result of that, our Earth temperature is already increased by, on an average, about 1 degree centigrade. Now, many people can say that what is a big deal? You know, 1 degree centigrade doesn't look like a big number. But actually, within 1 degree centigrade increase in the global temperature, the kind of activities that is taking place on the planet is very surprising, very dangerous. And I'm going to show you some example of that. So 1 degree is a huge change for such a big planet. So we should stop the global warming. That is what the target of the whole world is. So the Paris Agreement, very famous Paris Agreement, where every country come together in 2015 and decided that we should limit the global warming to 1.5 degree centigrade. How should we limit it? We should, you know, stop or reduce the carbon dioxide emission to about 50% level of 2015. So by 2030, in the next 10 years, our CO2 level should go down by 50%, which means that we have to cut down on the use of coal, petrol, diesel, LPG, CNG, kerosene by 50% in next 10 years. The truth is that it is actually increasing, you know, rather than going down. So the climate change scientists say that, okay, fine, you need to limit the global warming to ideally 1.5 degrees centigrade, if not 2 degrees centigrade. And 1.5 degrees is a very holy number in the climate science. You know why? Because if you allow the global warming to go beyond 1.5 degrees centigrade and up to 2 degrees centigrade, the change in the atmosphere, the climate will be irreversible. You will not be able to correct it. Even all of us become a saint. You know, hum sab log sadhu ban jaye aur sara carbon use karna band kar de aur fir kahe ki climate change ruk jayega. Nahi. Many people have this wrong impression that because of the coronavirus, the activity have reduced and pollution in the air has definitely decreased, but the climate change has not. Why? Because once you emit the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, it remains in the atmosphere for a very, very long time, tens and hundreds of years. So even if you become saint, it is not going to solve the problem. So earlier estimates suggest that 1.5 degrees centigrade we will reach by 2030, 2040. Then people came up with a new estimate says 2030. And this report, which came last month from the WMO, World Meteorological Organization, which says that there is a 20% chance that one of the next 5 years will be at least 1.5 degrees centigrade warmer than pre-industrial levels, right? 20% chance within next 5 years will be 1.5 degrees centigrade warmer. And the chance is increasing with the time. That is even dangerous, right? It is not that 20%. The next year it may increase higher, next year it may become higher. That is the kind of world we are living in. And there is a report that came from United Nations very recently. It says that heat is on. We are not correcting ourselves. The carbon dioxide emission has not reduced. It is in fact increasing. In 2018, it has increased by 1.7%. The renewable energy installation did not increase much in 2018. And the carbon dioxide concentration has reached to a level which has never been observed on this planet in the last 800,000 years. Pichle 8 lakh saalon mein is tarah ka carbon dioxide ka level dharti par observe nahi kiya gaya. So not only that we are doing it, not only that we are using more energy, but we are using more of everything else. You know, this there is something called Earth Overshoot Day, you know. So when we are overshooting, hum jarurat se zyada kab upyog karte hain? For example, aapka महीने का सैलरी 20,000 है या 50,000 है और आपने 50,000 की जगह 70,000 यूज करना चालू कर दिया. सो यू आर ओवरशूटिंग बाय 20%. एंड इफ यू आर ओवरशूटिंग योर रिसोर्सेज बाय 20%, दो चार महीने उधार लेके आप चला लोगे, बट यू विल ब्रेक डाउन सून. दैट इज व्हाट वी ह्यूमंस आर डूइंग विद द रिसोर्सेज ऑफ द प्लैनेट. यू नो वेदर इट इज वाटर, एयर, सॉइल, एवरीथिंग वी आर ओवर यूटिलाइजिंग. सो consume, and ideally the Earth Overshoot Day should come on December 31st, right? The 1 year consuming. But look at this below. Even in 1977, the Earth Overshoot Day came 60 days ahead of 31st December. And in last year, 2019, Earth Overshoot Day came on 29th July itself. Can you imagine? Almost within half a year, we are consuming all the resources that Mother Nature is regenerating. So what we do rest of time, what we do, baki samay hum kya karte hain? Baki samay hum resource rate hain. We steal it from others. Main hamesha kehta hun ki kisi se 100 rupaye liye aur usko wapas चुका दिए, उधार लिए और वापस चुका दिए, तो हमने बोला कि उसको लोन लिया था, राइट? पर यदि किसी से 100 रुपए लिए और वापस नहीं चुकाएंगे, यदि हमने पानी जमीन से पानी लेना सीख लिया ट्यूबवेल के माध्यम से, पर हमने पानी को रिचार्ज करना नहीं सीखा, सो व्हाट आर वी डूइंग? आर वी स्टीलिंग? यस, वेरी मच. इफ यू आर यू नो कटिंग ट्रीज बट वी आर नॉट प्लांटिंग द ट्रीज, व्हाट आर वी डूइंग? Yes, हमने नदियों का पानी पॉल्यूशन लेवल बिगाड़ तो दिया पर उसको करेक्ट नहीं किया, तो क्या हमने बदमाशी की? Yes. The whole thing is that the human of today have become a kind of a, you know, without really worrying about the mother nature. as a result of that, if you look at per capita resources are going down and down. Population is increasing, per capita land available is decreasing, per agricultural land is decreasing, per capita forest is decreasing, per capita fresh water is increasing. So we need and because we are doing all this thing, what we have done, we have created a major problem in the world. Unfortunately, 99% people are not aware. I'm trying to make you aware ki humne kya kya gadbad kiya. Let's look at the example. This is an image of an oil fire forest burning last year. Last year, dekha 1 lakh acre forest Australia mein aur Amazon mein burn hua. And government could not control it for months. And what happened? About 1 billion animals died. About 1 billion animals died. This sorry, I think it got disconnected. Are you able to see me again?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now it's fine.
And let me bring my screen back. Okay. Can you see my screen again?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. So our last image I showed you about the fire in the forest, and this image is exactly in contrast, the water. This image is from a city, Venice, in Italy. And last year, the water, sea water came inside and it did not reside. It did not come because of the flood. It was not because it was flooding, but it came because the sea, just water came in and remained like that for several days. This is an image of a continent, Europe, which is known for its beautiful weather, which is known for the snowfalls, you know, and we have seen in the Bollywood movies, you know, how beautiful the weather here is. But you look at last year, in one of the cities, the temperature in France went to 45.8 degrees centigrade. And I'm sure those who are living in India know what it means to go to 45 degrees centigrade. In summer, we go 45 degrees centigrade. So in the very cold continent, the temperature went to 45 degrees centigrade. On the other hand, this is an image of a Middle East, which is a desert, which is a warm subcontinent. And in this subcontinent, there was a snowfall. You know, you can see that the palm trees on the background. So you see how contrasting things are happening, where there is to be there is a fire, and then there's a water, and then there's snowfall. And then there's a high heat waves, which is also going right now in the many parts of the world. This is an image of our Rashtrapati Bhavan, and we know that how much was the problem of the smog. And for several days and days, the visibility was very poor, the pollution level was very high. This is Gurgaon, one of the kind of area. And what you see here, these cars are actually part of the traffic jam. Okay, they are not there because of the parking, they are there as a part of the traffic jam. So what I'm trying to say is we have created the world which is creating a problem for ourselves, you know. And why it is happening? Because the humans have not really understood the sustainability. And that's why I said, let us have a new look on the energy and sustainability. We have not really understood what sustainability is. And we are like a parrot, you know. Tote ko hum sikha dete hain ki acha, बोलो हे राम, तो तोता हे राम हे राम हे राम बोलता रहता है, पर उसको ये समझ नहीं आता कि इसका मतलब क्या होता है. सिमिलरली हमने कई सारे कॉन्फ्रेंसेस में, कई सारे टेक्स्ट बुक्स में सस्टेनेबिलिटी क्या होती है उसकी डेफिनेशन पढ़ी होगी, बट मेरे ख्याल से हमने कभी समझा ही नहीं कि सस्टेनेबिलिटी क्या होती है. अदरवाइज यू वुड नॉट हैव बीन डूइंग ऑल दिस थिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ सस्टेनेबिलिटी इज कि योर जनरेशन हैज टू बी इक्वल टू योर कंजम्पशन. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बी सस्टेनेबल मंथली, then your expenses has to be equal to your income. As simple as that. आप जितना पानी निकाल रहे हो जमीन से उतना डालने की जरूरत है. है ना, जितना पेड़ काट रहे हैं उतना लगाने की जरूरत है, जितना कमा रहे हैं उतना ही खर्च कर सकते हैं. दिस इज वेरी बेसिक सिंपल डेफिनेशन ऑफ सस्टेनेबिलिटी. एंड एंड गांधी जी सेड इट वेरी नाइसली. ही सेड दैट वी मे यूटिलाइज द गिफ्ट्स ऑफ द नेचर जस्ट एज वी चूज, बट इन हर बुक्स, इन द बुक्स ऑफ मदर नेचर, डेबिट्स आर ऑलवेज इक्वल टू क्रेडिट्स एंड देयर इज नो बैलेंस इन आइदर कॉलम. वी कैन नॉट क्रिएट एनी बैलेंस. जितना लिया है उतना वहीं के वहीं जमा करना पड़ेगा. दैट इज वॉट गांधी जी सेड इन द इन द इन 1932. He also went on to say that I suggest that we are thieves in a way. हम लोग एक तरह से चोर हैं. If I take anything that I do not need for my own immediate use and keep it, I thieve it from somebody else. यदि मैं अपनी जरूरत का नहीं है immediately और मैं लेते अपने पास रखता हूँ तो मैं एक तरह से चोरी कर रहा हूँ. And he further said, I venture to suggest that it is fundamental law of nature without exception that nature produces enough for our wants from day to day. And if only everybody took enough for himself, nothing more, there would be no pauperism in the world. दुनिया में गरीबी नहीं रहेगी, हमने यदि हमारी जरूरत का ही लिया दुनिया से. But ये तभी हो सकता है ये. But so long as we have got this inequality, so long as we are thieving. जब तक दुनिया में असमानता है, तब तक समझ लेना कि हम लोग चोरी कर रहे हैं. He said this in 1933. And he nicely summarized it. You know, Gandhiji was not a scientist. You know, he was not a Newton. He was not an Einstein who can, you know, formulate the laws and tell us. But he told things beautifully. He said, Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, not for every man's greed. सबकी जरूरत को पूरा कर सकता, लालच को नहीं. तो I have tried to put it in the form of fundamental law of nature. जैसे कि हमारे Newton's के law होते हैं, Einstein के laws होते हैं, वैसे ही हम गांधी जी की फिलॉसफी को एक लॉ ऑफ नेचर, फंडामेंटल लॉ ऑफ सस्टेनेबिलिटी बोल सकते हैं. क्यों बोल सकते हैं? क्योंकि दुनिया में हर कुछ फाइनाइट है. पृथ्वी का सरफेस एरिया फाइनाइट है. पृथ्वी में जितना पानी है वो फाइनाइट है, जितनी हवा है वो फाइनाइट है, जितनी जमीन है फाइनाइट है, जितना जंगल है, सब कुछ तो सीमित है. यदि सब कुछ सीमित है तो हमारा कंजम्पशन भी सीमित होना चाहिए, isn't it? पर हम ऐसे कंज्यूम करते हैं, मान लो हमारे पास पैसा हो तो एक घर खरीदेंगे, दूसरा खरीदेंगे, तीसरा खरीदेंगे. पैसा हो तो बहुत बड़ा गाड़ी खरीदेंगे, पैसा हो तो बाथटब में स्नान करेंगे, और ज्यादा पैसा हो तो स्विमिंग पूल बना लेंगे, isn't it? So we are constantly violating this fundamental law of sustainability. उसको मैंने इस तरह से फॉर्मुलेट किया है दैट इन एन इकोसिस्टम ऑफ फाइनाइट रिसोर्सेस देर कैन ओनली बी फाइनाइट कंजम्पशन. चूंकि हमारे अर्थ में सब कुछ फाइनाइट है, हमारा कंजम्पशन भी फाइनाइट ही होना चाहिए. और यू एंड आई सी दैट वी आर ब्लेटेंटली वॉयलेटिंग दिस लॉ. हम इस नियम का दिन रात उल्लंघन करते हैं. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ दैट आवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इज वेरी मच डिफरेंट. हम दुनिया की, हमारी समझ ही बहुत गड़बड़ है. तो ये 2019 में इंडिया टुडे में एक आर्टिकल आया था, उसका मैं आपको जस्ट बता रहा हूँ. यहाँ पे लिखा है, उसका इमेज ऐसा था कि जब इकोनॉमी स्लो डाउन हुई तो नंबर ऑफ कार्स का सेल कम हो गया. So then the article has written that it says the auto industry in the midst of severe slump, policy intervention are required to revive economy at large, necessary to stay off the protected crisis. बहुत लंबे समय तक क्राइसिस को कम करना है तो हमें कुछ ना कुछ पॉलिसी इंटरवेंशन लाना पड़ेगा. पॉलिसी इंटरवेंशन क्या होता है? जब इकोनॉमी स्लो डाउन होती है तो इंटरेस्ट रेट कम कर दो ताकि कंजम्पशन बढ़ जाए, इंटरेस्ट रेट कम कर दो ताकि कार की सेल बढ़ जाए, isn't it? So, हमारे इकोनॉमिस्ट का ये मानना है कि यदि इकोनॉमी को ठीक करना है तो क्या करना चाहिए? ऑटोमोबाइल सेल बढ़ाना चाहिए, कंजम्पशन बढ़ाना चाहिए. तो मेरे ख्याल से हम लोग प्रॉब्लम को समझते ही नहीं. सो व्हाट इज इन रियल सेंस क्राइसिस? हैविंग अ कार नॉट सोल्ड इज अ क्राइसिस और हैविंग अ कार सोल्ड इज अ क्राइसिस? कार का नहीं बिकना प्रॉब्लम है कि कार का बिकना प्रॉब्लम है? पहले तो हम ये डिसाइड करें. यदि कार बिकती है तो क्या होगा? यदि कार बिकती है तो पॉल्यूशन बढ़ेगा, फ्यूल कंजम्पशन बढ़ेगा, यू नो, ट्रैफिक जाम बढ़ेगा, मटेरियल का रिसोर्स कंजम्पशन होगा, एक्सीडेंट्स होंगे एंड इनइक्विटी बढ़ेगी दुनिया में. सो गांधी जी के हिसाब से तो कार बेचना ही प्रॉब्लम है. और आज के हमारे जो करंट जो इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट है जिसको हम बोलते हैं, वो बोलते हैं कि नहीं, कार का नहीं बेचना प्रॉब्लम है. तो पहले हम दुनिया में ये डिसाइड करें कि एक्चुअल में क्या प्रॉब्लम है. गांधी जी ने एक दूसरी बात भी कही थी जो कि बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. उन्होंने कहा था कि आई वुड कैटेगोरिकली स्टेट माय कन्विक्शन दैट द मैनिया ऑफ मास प्रोडक्शन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द वर्ल्ड क्राइसिस. दुनिया की जो प्रॉब्लम है, जो पागलपन है, मैनिया पागलपन है मास प्रोडक्शन का, वही दुनिया में समस्या का कारण है. तो वही हम आजकल कर रहे हैं. We want to make a big factories, we want to make a big, you know, malls, we want to make a big roads, we want to make a big house, you know, we want to do the mass production. He said that is a problem, but he has also given a solution. He said when production and consumption both become localized, production be local or consumption be local, then the temptation to speed up the production indefinitely and at any price disappears. All the endless difficulties and the problems that our present economy system presents, two would then come to an end. आज का जो हमारा economic system जो problem present करता है, वो भी खत्म हो जाएगा यदि हम local हो जाएं, है ना? And fortunately, this time Prime Minister spoke about it, you know, local for local. गांधी जी ने ये 100 साल पहले बोला था. इसलिए गांधी जी ने बोला कि नहीं, I do not like the mass production. What is required? Production by masses. यदि लोकली हम प्रोड्यूस करना स्टार्ट कर दें तो लोकल लेवल पे आर्थिक स्थिति स्ट्रांग होगी, इतना पॉल्यूशन नहीं होगा, हम लोग सेल्फ सफिशिएंट हो जाएंगे. और ऐसा इसलिए करना जरूरी है क्योंकि जब भी हम मास प्रोडक्शन करते हैं हम अनइक्वल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन करते हैं. जब भी मास प्रोडक्शन होगा कुछ लोगों के हाथों में उसका बेनिफिट होगा. जब भी मास प्रोडक्शन होगा, जो नाइकी के शूज का मास प्रोडक्शन हो रहा था उसके शेयर होल्डर के हाथ में ही उसका बेनिफिट जाएगा और बाकी लोग देखते रह जाएंगे. सो जो इनइक्विटी है दुनिया में, असमानता बढ़ती है जब भी हम मास प्रोडक्शन करते हैं, इसलिए सस्टेनेबिलिटी के खिलाफ है. जब भी इनइक्विटी बढ़ेगी दुनिया में, प्रॉब्लम बढ़ेंगे, वायलेंस बढ़ेंगे, ऑल काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स विल हैपन एंड दैट इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. सो इफ यू वांट सस्टेनेबल लाइफ वी हैव टू अवॉइड मास प्रोडक्शन एंड वी शुड डू प्रोडक्शन बाय मासेस. एंड व्हाई नॉट? बिकॉज पीपल आर लिविंग इन अ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड मैनर. माय एनर्जी नीड्स आर distributed. My energy needs are not one, but I am using 100 years old technology, coal power plant, nuclear power plant. एक जगह centralized production करेंगे, फिर उसको transformer और distribution line और इतना तामझाम करके उसको फिर अलग-अलग जगह पहुँचाएंगे. But people are living everywhere, not at centrally at one location. So चूंकि हमारी needs decentralized है, तो हमारा energy generation भी decentralized होना चाहिए. That is what is the second law, second fundamental law of sustainability. Which is again Gandhian philosophy, but I have put in these words that in an ecosystem of finite resources, there can only be a distributed production. You cannot have a centralized production. There has to be distributed production. So, is it really possible that we can have a distributed production? And I have founded this project last in IIT Bombay. We call it Solar Urja Through Localization for Sustainability. सोलर एनर्जी को हम लोकलाइज करें और सस्टेनेबल हो जाएं. सो इज इट रियली पॉसिबल? आई विल नॉट गो इनटू द डिटेल्स, बट आई एम गोइंग टू गिव सम एग्जांपल दैट हाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन एंड हाउ वी हैव डन. सो व्हाट वी हैव डन, वी हैव इंपावर्ड लोकल कम्युनिटी, मेनली वुमेन, टू असेंबल देयर ओन सोलर प्रोडक्ट्स एंड सोलर लैंप्स. सो वी गिव देम ट्रेनिंग हाउ टू आइडेंटिफाई द कंपोनेंट्स, व्हाट आर द टेक्निकल स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ कंपोनेंट, हाउ टू डू द सोल्डरिंग, हाउ टू पुट इट टुगेदर, हाउ टू टेस्ट इट if things are working or not working, etc. So we did that. Then we helped them to do the soldering. They actually started assembling the solar lamps. Not only they started assembling the solar lamps, they will go and sell the lamps. It is not given free and they will earn money out of it. Around 10,000 women were trained to do that. And it is so amazing to see when the money comes in their hand, how much life changes. You know, what is their status in the society changes, you know, what is their value in front of their mother-in-law changes and their husband changes. That's really amazing. What also we have done, we have helped them to do the installation of entire electricity connection at home. So the entire electricity installation can be done at home by themselves, right? The solar and wiring and everything. They can put everything on solar. And not only that, we have gone one step further and helped them to set up a local module manufacturing line. You know, when you set up a local module manufacturing line, you get further empowered to fulfill their own local needs. So this is a factory in Rajasthan, which is all owned by women and run by women. And this is called Durga Factory. where the CEO, the chief executive officer of this factory is Rukmani Devi, who is only 8th pass. You know, can you imagine women now talking about dollars and, you know, an exchange rate and procuring the material and talking to the collector and talking to the officers and, you know, running the show. So this SOULS program we have run in a huge scale, 8.5 million families we have reached, 10 states we have covered that are shown here in the image, 40,000 plus villages we have covered, we have trained more than 10,000 women, there were many repair centers that we opened, and now around more than 1,000 women are running the solar shops. You know, unki dukaanein chal rahi hain aur ye solar ke products sell karte hain. This is without any subsidy, without any financial support. And the products are sold at the commercial in the market way, and they earn about 5,000 to 10,000 rupees. So this is a small example of how one can be locally self-sufficient. So this gave me idea about Energy Swaraj, which is, you know, Gandhian philosophy of Gram Swaraj. How we can be locally self-sufficient, and why can't we be locally self-sufficient in terms of energy? Why can't we locally generate and produce our own energy needs? And so the next question comes in, is it really possible? Is it technologically feasible? Is it economically viable? You know, is it environmentally friendly? Can we do it at an institution level, and whether socially it is acceptable? Again, each of the topic can be discussed in a great detail, but I'm just going to give a gist of it that yes, technologically it is possible. The solar module technology, solar cell technology has evolved tremendously in the last 2 to 3 decades, and the prices have come down very significantly that one can really afford it now. You know, is it economically possible? Yes, the cost of solar electricity has come down. There are people who are selling solar electricity at the rate of 2.5 to 3 rupees per unit to the government, and if you go off the grid and make your own off-grid system, you can actually generate your own electricity as much as you want at the rate of about 5 to 6 rupees per unit, which is very competitive with respect to the grid electricity that you get. Is it environmentally friendly? Yes, that we all very know, the carbon footprint is much smaller than the electricity that we generate using coal. Is it institutionally doable? Yes, if you localize, there are lots of requirements of jobs. You know, every country, when the economic slowdown happens, every country suffers from the job loss. And decentralized way of production and generation is one beautiful way where you can actually give jobs to many people. And the kind of skills that is required to install solar power is really simply easily doable and definitely socially acceptable. So therefore, we have founded this Energy Swaraj Foundation to promote what we call energy by locals, for locals. And this is a not-for-profit foundation. It has been founded last year when we took part in this IEEE global competition. It was the competition was titled as Empowering Billion Lives. How do we empower billion people in the world? And we promoted this idea of being local, you know, being local in terms of assembly, supply, distribution, repair, and maintenance. And because we have done the project, we have demonstrated that actually it works and it creates a lot of opportunities for people. And we got this award at the global stage all over the world. More than 459 teams participated from all the continents. And we got this award of $100,000. So I donated that money to this foundation. And this foundation was founded last year when it was 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Now, I must warn that before we go and put everything on solar, and by the way, Energy Swaraj Foundation is running one of the campaign where we are persuading people to surrender electricity connection. Apna bijli ka connection chhod ke solar pe jaye. Puri tarah chhod ke. Connection katwa ke solar pe jaye. And there are many people now who are coming forward. We are talking to them ki wo hamein solar solution provide karenge aur apna bijli ka connection chhodenge. तो हमेशा के लिए बिजली के बिल से मुक्ति मिल सकती है. नो राइट नाउ दिस कैंपस आई एम सिटिंग इन मध्य प्रदेश, दिस इज 100% सोलर पावर्ड कैंपस, दिस इज कॉल्ड एजुकेशन पार्क. और पिछले 10 सालों से यहाँ पर बिजली का कनेक्शन लिया ही नहीं गया है, जो भी चलता है यहाँ पे सोलर पे चलता है. बट बिफोर वी डू दैट वी नीड टू फॉलो व्हाट आई कॉल इज AMG प्रिंसिपल. यू नो, वी नीड टू फर्स्ट अवॉइड यूज ऑफ एनर्जी एज मच एज वी कैन. जितना संभव हो सके हमें एनर्जी का उपयोग को अवॉइड करना चाहिए। क्यों करना चाहिए? क्योंकि सोलर पावर भी कार्बन फुटप्रिंट कुछ है, जीरो नहीं है, राइट। तो यदि मैं सोलर पावर यूज करता हूँ, मैंने घर में चार एसी लगा दिए हैं और मैं चारों एसी को सोलर पे कर लिया, एंड देन आई एम फीलिंग हैप्पी कि अरे मैंने इतना बढ़िया काम कर दिया, नो, यू नो देयर इज सेइंग इन हिंदी कि 900 चूहे खाके बिल्ली हज को चली, यू नो, आपने इतना पॉल्यूशन कर दिया, इतना मटेरियल यूज कर दिया और फिर आप बोलेंगे कि हम सोलर पे कर रहे, दैट इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क। सो अवॉइड यूज ऑफ एनर्जी इवन इफ इट इज सोलर एनर्जी। In my experience, I can tell you that if you can become aware about this and start avoiding use of energy, 1/3 of energy or electricity you can easily avoid. And if you can do, if you cannot avoid, then you need to what is do minimize use of energy. Minimize का मतलब है कि हम लोग efficient energy appliances use करें। आजकल light, fan, TV, washing machine, refrigerator सब लोग बहुत high rating में सब appliances बहुत high rating में आने लगे। और जब हाई एनर्जी रेटिंग होती है, हाई स्टार रेटिंग होती है, तो बहुत कम एनर्जी का कंजम्पशन करते हैं। तो जब हम अच्छे एफिशिएंट अप्लायंस और खास करके डीसी अप्लायंस आने लगे कि हम लोग डीसी में उसको चला सकते हैं, तो जब डीसी अप्लायंसेस आते हैं तो हम लोग बहुत कम इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यूज करके उसको सेम फंक्शन ले सकते हैं। सो जब मिनिमाइज करेंगे तो 1/3 एनर्जी का यूज हो जाएगा, और 1/3 अवॉइड कर दिया, 1/3 मिनिमाइज कर दिया, तो जो बचा 1/3 है बहुत आसानी से यू कैन स्टार्ट जनरेटिंग विद द सोलर। सो आई से दैट वी मस्ट फॉलो द एएमजी प्रिंसिपल इफ यू वांट टू अवॉइड सेइंग ओएमजी, ओ माय गॉड सोलर इज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव, इजंट इट। एंड इफ यू कैन एक्चुअली ब्रिंग एनर्जी स्वराज इन द कंट्री एंड इन द वर्ल्ड, वी कैन रियली क्रिएट अ सस्टेनेबल लाइफ, वी कैन क्रिएट लॉट ऑफ लाइवलीहुड अपॉर्चुनिटीज, यू नो, वी कैन स्ट्रेंथन द लोकल इकोनॉमी, वी कैन क्रिएट स्किल्स, we will provide job opportunities at the local area, we can become energy independent, individually you can become energy independent, the country can become energy independent, because we import lot of energy and we spend lot of money importing energy. Also it affects the security of the country, it affects the sovereignty of the country. So once we become energy independent, there are many 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 benefits of doing it. So last year I did a Gandhi Global Solar Yatra. I went around the world. I went to many countries and and told them how solar energy is useful, how serious the climate change is, and how there is a need to wake up immediately so that we can together find a solution before it becomes too late. यदि बहुत ज़्यादा late किया हमने climate solution को find करने में, तो मेरे ख्याल से हम लोग जैसे मैंने कहा था साधु भी बन जाएंगे, तो क्लाइमेट सॉल्यूशन क्लाइमेट चेंज को बचा नहीं पाएंगे। व्हाट आई हैव डन इज देयर इज ओनली प्लेनेट ए, सिर्फ मदर नेचर है जहां पर हम रह सकते हैं, देयर इज नो अदर प्लेनेट इन द एंटायर यूनिवर्स, वी नीड टू सेव इट समहाउ। सो आई हैव टेकन अ लीव फ्रॉम आईआईटी बॉम्बे, अ वेरी लॉन्ग लीव, एंड देन आई एम प्लानिंग व्हाट इज कॉल्ड एनर्जी स्वराज यात्रा। सो दिस इज अ यात्रा आई एम गोइंग टू, वी आर डिजाइनिंग अ सोलर पावर्ड बस, विद दिस बस आई एम गोइंग टू गो अराउंड in the country, talk to people as many as possible, ask them to surrender electricity connection, go 100% on solar energy. So any one of you want to join, and I also feel that it has to become a public movement. ये एक जन आंदोलन बनने की जरूरत है, energy स्वराज एक movement बनने की जरूरत है। तो इसको जन आंदोलन बनाने के लिए यात्रा करने की जरूरत है। तो आप में से कोई भी यदि आंदोलन join करना चाहते हैं, energy स्वराज यात्रा में join करना चाहते हैं, so you go to our website energyswaraj.org, www.energysuraj.org, and once you go there you can actually find the ways in which you can become part of the Energy Swaraj movement, and all of you can stay in touch with me. These are the various social media pages that I have, and I keep posting many things, so if you really want you can be associated with this and with the Energy Swaraj Foundation. So with this I would really like to thank the principal and the organizers for inviting me, and I will be very happy to answer your queries. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir, for such a motivating and inspiring lecture. So I'm inviting questions now. Please, you can write in the chat box any questions.
So I hope after listening to this talk, people are happy still. You're happy?
Yeah, very happy.
Good. So that is the biggest contribution anybody can make in this world, is to be happy, you know. Just ensure that we're all happy. And I keep saying that there are two types of pollution we spread. One is the pollution to the atmosphere, and other pollution is what is called emotional pollution, you know. जब हम लोग ऐसा मुरझाया हुआ लटका हुआ चेहरा दुखी चेहरा लेके इधर उधर जाते हैं तो लोगों पर उसका प्रभाव पड़ता है ना, दुष्प्रभाव पड़ता है. सो प्लीज डू नॉट स्प्रेड द इमोशनल पॉल्यूशन, एटलीस्ट मेक दैट एज अ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द वर्ल्ड एंड कीप स्माइलिंग. ग्रेट. सो क्वेश्चन,
योर हैंड्स प्लीज पोस्ट योर क्वेश्चंस सो आई विल टेक वन बाय वन. Enable, Ravinder, please enable the chat. It's not enabled. Ravinder?
I'm done. I'm open to the chat box. Haan, ma'am, chat box open to the chat box. Just
wait for five. Theek hai, fine, fine. Because students are raising their hands. Any questions, please? Yeah, this is in Telangana, sir. Any training centers?
Well, basically what we are trying to do is we are creating what we call is Energy Swaraj Ashrams. So this Energy Swaraj Ashrams are, we are partnering with the local institutions. And this Energy Swaraj Ashrams are nothing but the incubation centers. They are solar incubation centers. And in this incubation centers, we kind of give training to the final year students. We help them to become entrepreneur. We help them to start their own companies. We also help them to procure material and do the marketing. Because, you know, Energy Swaraj is energy by local for local. And so that is the whole idea. And if anybody is interested to start a training center or the solar energy Swaraj Ashram in any places, you can actually go to our website and apply for it, and then we can respond. Somebody is saying energy, solar energy is very costly comparing to regular electricity. Is there any chance to economic circumstances? Thank you very much, Mr. Venkat Krishna, to ask this question. And I would really like to answer that. Probably you're not understood, again, you know, what sustainability is. Probably you're not understood how dangerous situation we are living in. You know, तो जब हम लोग मान लो एक example देता हूँ कि हम लोग boat में जा रहे हैं, एक river को cross करना है, और इस पार से उस पार जाने का जो किराया है वो 10 रुपए है, और आप बीच में गए 10 रुपया देके बोट में गए, बीच में नदी के बीच में उलट गई बोट, एंड समहाउ जो जो नाविक था उसने बचा लिया, बोट को ठीक कर लिया, एंड देन यू आर स्टिल इन वाटर. और नाविक ने बोला कि नहीं नहीं मैं आपको अभी पार कराने के 100 रुपए लूंगा, राइट? सो व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू डू? आर यू गोइंग टू डाई सिंक योरसेल्फ, और यू आर गोइंग टू आर्ग्यू कि नहीं 10 रुपए का किराया 100 रुपए क्यों लेते हो? So what I'm saying is you need to realize that we are in such a difficult and dangerous situation, and we cannot make these decisions and judgment based on the economics. By the way, I told you already that so people are selling electricity of solar at 2.5 to 3 rupees, and there are, you just Google search, you'll find the rates, and you're paying bill at 5.5 to 6 rupees per unit at your home. So it is definitely very cheap. But what I'm saying is don't adopt solar energy because it is cheap. Adopt solar energy because it is required to save the future of yourself and your children. Be selfish. अपने हम लोग हमेशा अपने बच्चों के लिए मेहनत करते हैं, काम करते हैं, कुछ नहीं तो अपने बच्चों को स्केयर वाली जिंदगी जीना ना पड़े कि डर के रहें बच्चे कि अरे आज कोरोना आया, अगले साल पता नहीं क्या होगा, फिर बारिश होगी कि नहीं, ठंड पड़ेगी कि नहीं, सूखा तो नहीं पड़ जाएगा, गर्मी की यू नो हीट वेव्स तो नहीं आ जाएगी. दिस इज द वर्ल्ड वी आर क्रिएटिंग फॉर अवर चिल्ड्रन. We are creating a very scary world. So be selfish and take care of your own children and do not do things. So do not adopt to solar because it is cheaper. Do adopt to solar because it is the way of life and it is the only sustainable way of life. There cannot be any other way of life. So please grow up and raise yourself and go to the cross this boundary and then go to the higher level and adopt solar energy. देन ओनली एज आई सेड एनर्जी स्वराज हैज टू बी अ मूवमेंट, है ना, जन आंदोलन की जरूरत है, ये सरकारों के द्वारा पॉलिसी के द्वारा नहीं होने वाला है.
Thank you, sir. Rightly said. Now, this is another question from Dr. Renuka. What basic requirement of environment to start local solar plant?
Requirement of environment? No, there is absolutely no requirement. Even if you are living in a place which is cloudy or there is rains, you can still start a solar plant. I'm just here right now, you know, recording another course, where I'm demonstrating that even in a cloudy condition, there is enough solar radiation that falls. Even in cloudy monsoon month, place gets about 60 to 70% solar radiation. So you can fulfill your requirement even in the monsoon condition. And as I said, this campus where I'm sitting, since last 10 years, though no electricity connection is ever taken. And it 100% runs on solar energy even in monsoon season. So there is no specific requirement. You can just generate wherever you are, in whatever environment you're living in.
Sir, okay. This is a question from Anushka. Can we even use solar cells for large purposes, like in businesses or companies?
Of course, you can do. I mean, recently the Prime Minister has inaugurated a 750 megawatt power plant, you know. 750 megawatt power plant is a huge power plant. You know, all many big cities you can run in 750 megawatt. So solar has the capacity that it can run your small calculator. You know, it can be so tiny that you can run your calculator on solar energy, and it can be as huge that you can run your entire city on solar energy. So it has such a beautiful flexibility to do that. So any size is okay.
Thank you, sir. This is a question from Anupama Jain. Why are we not switching to solar energy now? And why government is still letting run these coal electricity generation?
Well, that's a very good question, and only thing I can tell that I don't think, as I said in the beginning, people do not understand what is happening. And how many percent? 99% people do not understand what is happening, which also includes our policy makers and our politicians. You know, many people do not even realize how difficult and dangerous it is. You know, for example, how fast the glaciers are melting, you know. For, another example is right now, as I'm talking, there is a place called Siberia, you know, in the part of Russia, which used to be covered with the snow all the time. Right now, the temperatures in Siberia are 10 degrees centigrade above the normal. Can you imagine? 10 degrees centigrade. For example, in summer in India, the temperature goes to 45 degrees centigrade. Imagine, instead of 45 degree, it becomes 55 degrees centigrade. What will happen? So what I'm saying is people at large, 99% people have no idea what is happening. They have no idea how criminal is the way we are living for the planet. They have no idea. You do not know how much problem that we are creating for ourselves. You do not realize, you know, for example, a simple activity of brushing your teeth. I'm sure everybody is brushing your teeth, right? I hope you are all doing it. Great. If you're not doing, do that. You know? So brushing your teeth itself is such a high energy consumption. And I'll give an example. For example, if you're brushing your teeth, I'm sure you're using a toothpaste. Somebody has to manufacture the toothpaste in a factory. Then it has to be packaged. Then it has to be put in another cover. Then that has to be transported to the mall or shop. Then mall or shopkeeper keep the toothpaste for a couple of months before you buy it. And it is using all kind of lights and air conditioning. Then you buy the toothpaste and then go there by some vehicle, you bring it to your home, then use the toothpaste, right? So look at the journey of the toothpaste that is covered. Same thing happens with the toothbrush. Same thing happens to your wash basin. Your wash basin is a ceramic. Ceramic is a very high temperature. It requires to melt. So somebody has melted ceramic to very high temperature and made the wash basin for you. Then somebody has made the mirror for you. Mirror is a quartz. Again, it is a very high energy consuming material. It takes a lot of energy before you can make a mirror. Somebody has made a pipe for you. You know, somebody has made a motor for you. And then you have to still use electricity to pump the water to higher up in your tank so that you can actually get the water in your tap every single day morning. So just an activity of brushing your teeth can consume so much energy that you're not aware. Imagine what else we do in the day-to-day life. So I think the misplaced sense of what is happening. As I told you, you need to figure out whether having a car sold is a problem or not, or having a car not sold is a problem. Let us realize what is the problem. And 99% people do not realize where is the problem. And that is why we do not solve the problem. I hope I have not confused you more.
No, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, another question from Garima. What to do in rainy areas where rain is continuously, the rainy months are continuously there for 2 to 3 months?
Well, I mean, as I said, even if the rainy areas, first of all, there can be some alternative arrangement. But I would say that even in rainy area, what happens that the sunlight is definitely not there, but the light that comes through the clouds also can generate electricity. And I'm making a video. I will release it on the Solar News and Knowledge channel on YouTube. By the way, I have designed a course which is free this month. You can do that and you can design your own solar system. So what I'm saying is, even through the cloud, there is some amount of solar radiation that falls in. You know, places even in like Mumbai, which rains heavily during the monsoon, you get almost 50% of radiation when the clear sun, as compared to clear sun. Which means that if you over design your system by 50%, you should be able to fulfill your energy needs even in the monsoon when it is raining. And as I said, the best thing is minimize your energy needs. That will help you further. Somebody asked me a question, you know, why did I went to TIS? You know, Suraj Kashyap asked. Well, after my MTech, I wanted to work for the social organizations, and I thought it is better to use, because I did my master's in microelectronics, and I thought if I design ICs and it is not going to be useful for villages immediately, and I wanted to do something which is of immediate use. So I thought that Tata Institute of Social Science would be able to kind of take me as a student, and I would be able to do something. But by my qualifications was not there to study social science, and therefore I was not admitted.
Sir, this is a question from Palina. Can incubation center be started in villages or only in institutions?
Well, I would say that it's better to start in an institution, because incubation centers require some kind of ecosystem, right? It requires technical know-how. It requires marketing. It requires some funding. It requires use of the communication and the promotion network. So therefore, I would suggest that the young people who are graduating from the institution, where we can have the incubation center. Now, the person who is starting to start a company should not be remain in the incubation center. That person has to really go out, and he can go to villages. He or she can go to the cities and start providing energy solution. But I feel that the center should be placed where we can actually help and nurture it with the right environment.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, this is a question from Shobhik. We know soiling of solar panel is a major issue, and especially in places where there is very little water, like in deserts. How can we address it?
Well, I mean, so there are techniques that are being developed. First of all, that there is enough moisture in the atmosphere, and there are salt with the high critical humidity. I'm sorry, low critical humidity. So what does it mean that if you put a salt in the atmosphere, what does it happen? You know, our salt that we eat, if you put it in the monsoon season on the table, it becomes wet, right? So salt has capacity to absorb the moisture, and there are salt which has higher capacity to absorb the moisture. And even my students have demonstrated that you can actually collect significant amount of water from the moisture, from the atmosphere, even in desert area, and you can use that as in water. So that is one thing. Then there are people who are developing a kind of anti-soiling coating so that you can put it on the module, and the kind of amount of soil that gets deposited will be less as compared to the no anti-soiling coating. So there are many efforts that are going in the world to ensure that the cleaning of the module happens with the minimum resources.
Thank you, sir. So this is a question from Harkirat. Can you please share your views on the new policy by the AAP government in Delhi with regards to the electric vehicles, especially whether you think that is enough for our current condition?
Well, I mean, thanks for asking question. First of all, the policy of the Delhi government for electricity is very bad policy. You know, the 200 units free is a really, really bad policy. And what it has resulted in, it has resulted in a misuse of electricity rather than use of electricity. And given a chance, I would like to, you know, make a court case against the government that, you know, this is really not fair to do that. Yes, the Delhi government can give as much money to the people as they want. You know, they can give 10,000 rupees every month to all the people. That is not a problem. But what I feel is, let people pay for electricity. And whenever you pay for something, you become sensitive. And the 200 units free is actually making people less sensitive about it. So that is really not the right policy. And I think not only Delhi government, but many other governments actually have this policy of, you know, free electricity and subsidized electricity, which is also a big reason for the kind of pollution. So we need to really change that. In terms of electric vehicles, I'm not sure what exactly the policy is, but eventually we need to drive our lives, whether it is the cooking or lighting, fan, or even transportation on solar energy. So if there is anything like that, I think it is a welcome policy.
Thank you, sir. Sir, this is from Raj Bala, that rate of installation of solar panel is very high. Can you suggest any other method, which is an approach of a simple man?
Well, I mean, I think the solar panels are very simple. There are also flexible panels that are available. You can just paste it on the walls. You can paste it on your rooftop. Those things are also available. But otherwise, there are ways in which you can use solar panel very effectively. You can use solar panel as a structural material, you know. So for example, if you need to create a top roof, your solar panel can become a roof. So it will do the double function. It can actually help you to save the material that you are going to put otherwise. Also, you can make a transparent solar panel. So not only that you can generate electricity, it can give you light. You can put solar panels in the walls, of course, with the compromise with the generation that will happen. So there are many ways you can install, and it's very easy. I mean, the structure are available easily, and I don't think it's really difficult to install solar panels.
Thank you, sir. It's a related question by Dr. D.C. Krishna. How much investment is required to set up a solar plant on a 200 square yards house?
200 square yards house, how much solar panels required? I mean, so first of all, you know, you need to figure out how much energy is required. And whether you are living a life which is sustainable or you are living a life which is creating problem for others. As I said, give an example, if you have 200 square yards out and if you have a lot of devices and appliances which are recklessly running, then nobody can help you. But if you are sensible and fulfilling all your energy requirement using solar, I think you can actually do a good amount of energy generation is about, let's say, 2 lakh rupees. So in 2 lakh rupees, I would say that you can generate 300 units of electricity every month, which is a very significant amount. You know, I'll give example of my house in Mumbai. I live in IIT Mumbai campus. And right now, our electricity consumption per month is about 60 to 70 units only. Because we have avoided many things, we minimized many things, and our energy requirements are very little. So when it is 60 to 70 units, 50,000 rupees is what are required that I can luxuriously spend on solar energy and fulfill all my energy requirements. So what I'm saying is, follow AMG principle, it will be very cheap. You will be surprised. If you want to know how cheap it is, you can go to our website, energyswaraj.org. There are calculators. You can give your requirements and it will show you how in various possible combination you can actually generate electricity and what are the expenses. So it will tell you the expenses also.
Thank you, sir. Sir, this is a question from Aman Srivastav. Is government helping in keeping solar panels at residential level interconnected to grid?
Yes, government do help in promoting the solar panel on the rooftop and connected to the grid. I believe that whatever government does is so slow that it is not going to be enough to mitigate climate change. Take my words, write it down. And it is not true for our government only. It is true for all the governments all across the world. And I told you last year, I went across the world, 30 countries that I visited in every continent. So all across the world, government do not have capacity right now to act fast enough to mitigate the climate change, because the climate change is happening very, very fast. Before you wake up, you will already be out of control. So I would say that do not wait for the government policy and subsidy. And that's why when I say Energy Swaraj movement means we go beyond economics, beyond policies, beyond subsidies. We do it because we worry for our own children and grandchildren. That's why we do it. We do it because we worry for our nature, so that it stays, we can live for longer, long time. By the way, if you're not aware, you know, I keep saying that, I give an example that we say that once upon a time, there were dinosaurs on the planet, right? We say that, right? Now, dinosaurs are not there on the planet, but once upon a time, they were there. Now, it is estimated that with the current policies that governments all over the world are making, the planet will still be 3 to 5 degrees centigrade warmer by the end of the century. By the limit is 1.5 to 2 degrees centigrade, but planet will go to 3 to 5 degrees centigrade warmer by end of this century. And if that happens, I think it is not wrong to say that the extinction of human would happen sooner or later, may not be in 50 years, 100 years, but maybe 150 years. Then I keep saying that a new kind of species will appear on the planet some few thousand years later. And they will say, once upon a time, there were humans on the planet. I hope you don't want to create such a situation and want to solve it as soon as possible. So do not wait for the government or policy or subsidies. Just do it, because it needs to be done. That's as simple as that.
Thank you, sir. Sir, we'll take a couple of questions more. This is from Anushka. Can we use wind or hydro energy too in that case? Is there any case that solar energy is very popular among all renewables? If so, what is the reason?
Well, the beauty of the solar energy is that it is available at your rooftop, right? The river doesn't go to everybody's house, isn't it? You can't actually design things on the hydropower because it doesn't flow everywhere. On the other hand, sunlight is available on every single rooftop. Second thing is the beauty of sunlight, solar energy is that you can run your calculator and you can run your house and you can run your city and you can run your industry, whichever, whatever you want. So that gives the flexibility, right? Third thing is that the solar technology has evolved in a manner that it has become competitive in terms of the rates, even with the grid electricity, even with the coal electricity. And that makes it very attractive. Solar energy is a modular in nature. So you today, if you want to install 1 kilowatt system and tomorrow you have increased needs and you want to make it 2 kilowatt system, you can do that. So the modularity also helps us. And it is very simple, right? It doesn't really take much to install solar energy. Very simple. And if you go to DC system, 48 volt system, it becomes shockproof also. No, you can touch at 48 volt system, you can touch any part of the system anywhere, you'll never get a shock. So there are many benefits of solar energy, and that's why it has become so popular. And other renewable energy technology has some limitation of availability, size, minimum size, etc. So probably one last question.
Yes, sir. This is from Sumit Yadav. Sir, you told about that selling and production of more cars and automobiles is a real problem. But sir, on looking at the economy side, these sectors are also one of the largest contributors in nation's economy. So how nation can balance with strengthening both the economy and environment at the same time?
Well, I mean, what we are trying to solve, or what scientists or what the economists or policymakers are trying to do, they are trying to tweak a little bit here and there and solve the problems. This little tweaking here and there can only solve the problems temporary. You know, for example, if economy is slowing down, you can definitely reduce the interest rate and pump and push the economy. Is it going to solve your economic problem forever, or is it only for this year? It is going to be only for this year, isn't it? So therefore, I think until unless we relook entirely, do not try to make adjustment here and there, you will not be able to solve the problem. Again, I'm saying write it down. You will not be able to solve the problem. until unless we relook entirely the energy, the sustainability, what Gandhiji has said, why we have digressed so much from his path, we are not going to sustain. Not going to sustain, no matter what you do, no matter how advanced your science is, no matter how advanced your technology is. As I said, the two things I told is a fundamental law of sustainability. And any law you violate, you are in trouble. There is only enough on the planet for everybody's need, not for the greed. If you are going to violate this law, you are going to suffer and disappear one day from this planet. Not the mass production, but production by mass is required. If you are going to violate this law, one day you are going to fight among yourself. You'll become a very violent society and you are going to disappear from the planet. These are the very fundamental laws of nature, of the sustainability. Do not dare to violate them. That is what I would say. If you do that, welcome. Karo ya maro. You know, choice is yours.
Thank you, sir. Sir, your talk has really motivated and inspired us. And it was really informative. And we and also our students will really benefit from it. And you rightly said that energy is the main driver of life. Every minute we are using it and energy is everything. हमने sustainability का अर्थ समझा ही नहीं और जितना लिया है उतना हमें देना ही पड़ेगा आगे अगर हमें survive करना है. And we are constantly violating environmental law of sustainability. We and our students, we would be really happy and privileged to be associated with the Energy Swaraj movement and also for the yatra that you are planning. And we are really inspired and awestruck by the amount of work that you have done in the area of energy sustainability, and you have been rightly called as the Solar Man of India or Solar Gandhi. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation to give us such an enlightening talk on energy sustainability. I would also like to thank our principal for his constant motivation and guidance. And because of that, we were able to organize more than 60 webinars during the COVID pandemic. I would also like to thank all the students, researchers, and teachers and participants who have joined us to be a part of this great webinar. I would also like to thank my colleague, Dr. Amit Vishwakarma, for having coordinated and arranged this webinar on such a relevant and pertinent topic. Finally, I would like to thank my entire webinar committee of Dr. Anju Bajaj, Dr. Raghvendra, Dr. Amit Vishwakarma, Ms. Anupriya Arora, Ms. Baljeet Kaur, Mr. Ravinder Pant, our technical man, and Mr. Manvendra and Mr. Abid Hussain. Without them, this webinar wouldn't have been possible. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for coming and accepting our invitation. We are really happy.
Thank you. And be happy and remain happy. I think that is a bigger contribution than solving the environment problem. So just keep smiling, everyone who's listening, and keep spreading the smile. And when the smile is there, your mind is happy. And when the mind is happy, it will always do the right thing that is required. So thank you once again, and all the best to everyone. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.